Can cars really drive themselves today? Yeah, yeah, we know, Tesla owners, what you'd probably say. But the reality is, the answer to that question is a bit complicated. Lucky for you, you clicked on this video, so I get to break down all the complexities of self-driving car tech and give you tips that could help save your life or the lives of your passengers or fellow motorists. But first, make sure you like and subscribe to our channel and be sure to visit Edmunds.com to find your next car. Also, if you want to read a bit more in depth on this topic, click the link below for our full article. All right, first off, you may have heard or seen the term autonomous driving. That's a fancy car nerd term that describes what we casually refer to as self-driving cars. Basically, a car that can do it all on its own.
Show me.
Not so fast though. There are levels on the road to autonomy, levels that the Professional Association of Engineers, also known as SAE International, came up with. It's worth saying that currently today, there are no autonomous or fully self-driving cars for sale on the market. Not even close. But I'm getting way ahead of myself. There are two main groups that you should know about, and within those groups, there are levels. In the first group, a vehicle may have varying types of support systems, features like automatic emergency braking or lane keeping assist, but the driver still is required to be active and engaged at all times. This group is level 0 through 2, which I'll break down the differences in each in just a sec. Levels 3 through 5 deal with vehicles that have partially or fully automated driving systems where the technology can take complete control of driving without human supervision.
This car's a pretty good driver.
This is nuanced and where most of the confusion happens because there's a big difference between level 3 and 4, let alone 5. Now to be clear, as of this recording, there are no vehicles currently being sold in the US that even reach level 3. Level 4 and level 5, none of those either.
I hate to be the one to break this to you, but automobiles are not human.
All right, let's get into each level. Level 0 is kind of self-explanatory. It means you're probably in a vehicle that has no driving automation technology. So you, as the driver, are completely in control and in charge of operating the car's movement. But there may be a momentary support system like forward collision warnings or automatic emergency braking that can kick in for a little extra assist. The vast majority of vehicles you see on the road right now, especially older ones, are level 0. Level 1 is pretty basic in that it's a vehicle that has at least one driver support system that provides steering assistance or braking and acceleration assistance like adaptive cruise control. As the driver, you're responsible for being in control of the vehicle at all times.
They're going the wrong way!
How would he know where we're going?
Nearly all new cars and trucks sold today are available with features that can meet or exceed this level.
Yeah!
So let's say you have both the adaptive cruise control and an active steering feature like lane centering assist. What does that mean? Well, that means you jumped to level 2. Good for you. Level 2 is the very last stop before we head into the second group where there is more significant automation. In this level, as well as the previous ones, you'll find cars that have more examples of what's called advanced driver assistance systems, or ADAS, allowing your car to take over things like steering, acceleration, and braking, sometimes even hands-free. But as the driver, you must still remain alert and you're required to actively supervise driving at all times. You might have heard of General Motors Super Cruise or Ford's Blue Cruise. These and others are all level 2s, which can only be activated when certain conditions are met, like clear road markings or there's a barrier separating you from oncoming traffic. Now, this may come as a surprise, Elon fans, but Tesla's autopilot and full self-driving systems are also level 2 under these rules, which make those names dangerously misleading because these cars cannot actually drive themselves.
So it just crossed the double yellow. I would get pulled over if I drove the way the autopilot's driving right now.
Now this is where things get interesting. Kind of like the futuristic cars we've all seen in the movies. The leap from level 2 to level 3 automation is significant. Level 3 is known as conditional driving automation, which basically means it's a combo of driver assist and artificial intelligence guiding your car if and when certain conditions are met. However, you still need to be present and able to take control whenever the car requests it. So no, sorry to say, you can't safely climb into the back and start reading that novel you said you'd always finish. Not here. Even though a level 3 vehicle is not on the market just yet, companies like Mercedes-Benz say they're very close. But many companies think a level 3 car is a mistake, giving drivers a false sense of security. No.
Lauren!
Oh. My bad. I'm sorry. It seems I dozed off like some Tesla owners do at the wheel. Shade! But no, seriously, it's really no joking matter when you're taking a nap or totally checked out in a car that you think is a level 4 or 5, which are fully self-driving, and you're really not. I hate to burst your futuristic bubble. Which means, yeah. Woohoo! Wake up! I know you paid a lot of money for that, Tessie, but it definitely cannot safely drive itself.
I'm afraid I can't do that.
Level 4 means the car doesn't need a human driver. You are not a factor.
Where am I?
You're in a Johnny Cab.
It is programmed to stop itself on its own if there's a problem or if certain conditions aren't met, like bad weather conditions, sorry Midwest. Or if it goes outside the area it's trained to drive in. Since a human driver is never needed, a level 4 vehicle may not have a steering wheel and pedals. Can you imagine? But the reality is that won't necessarily always be the case, as it can still have controls if a driver wants it. Examples of level 4 cars are testing out in the real world right now in geo-fenced environments. You may have seen or even ridden in prototype self-driving shuttles like those from Google's Waymo. But while you may be able to catch a ride, no, you still can't own your own. And yes, at level 4, you can take a nap while driving, or in this case, riding in the car. Level 5 is the absolute highest you can go in automation according to SAE International, as you remember, the professional association of engineers who developed these standards. They're also the same people who decided how we measure horsepower and a whole bunch of other aerospace stuff. Basically, they're smart. The biggest difference between level 4 and 5 is that level 5 doesn't require that any particular driving conditions need to be met. These vehicles work rain or shine, or snow, and even in any place on Earth at any time. Unfortunately, right now, level 5 is basically theoretical. Though I've had some fun with these levels, the truth of the matter is, not understanding these, and more importantly, driving without an awareness of these levels and the type of automation your vehicle is capable of, can be dangerous for you and whoever is riding with you or around you. I hope this info is helpful, and please click on the link below to learn more about each level and what the future holds. We may not be in the George Jetsons world yet.
James, stop this crazy thing!
But it feels like we're on our way, and you don't want to be the last to know about how all this technology works. Did you know we have a top 10 for every vehicle category? So check out Edmunds.com no matter what kind of car, truck, or SUV you're searching for.